The thaw begins. The warm embrace of nature. The therapy that is drinking a bottle of Irish whiskey and yelling at the away keeper. And, of course, making poorly written and edited videos hating on other clubs. 8 week arrives for the third year in a row, and the soccer gods demand blood. What better sacrifice than our first opponent, the Colorado Springs Switchbacks FC. A club that we have included in past 8 weeks, but I feel we haven't given them their due and proper. Let's take a closer look, and maybe we can also figure out what the fuck a switchback is.
Bali chalhoge, bali mangti kali maa.
The tracks are laid on December 5th, 2013. An ownership group based in Colorado Springs are awarded a franchise. Debuting in 2015, the club was named Colorado Springs Switchbacks FC following a fan contest. They picked that name. Led by coach Steve Tritschew, the Switchbacks would find success in their first season. With Luke Vercoloni as their top goal scorer, the Switchbacks would finish third in the West and make the playoffs. Their postseason would end in the conference semifinals with the energy showing them the door. Work would need to be done in preparation for the following year, and perhaps a new fence to keep all those damn goats out. In the team's second season, good times were still to be had, still with coach Tritschew and retaining key players from last year. They even had the blue man running around pumping up the crowd. He reminds me of the blue meanie. Man, I bet that guy has some good acid.
Have the sunshine acid.
Again, they would finish third in the West, making the postseason, but unable to get out of the first round, losing at home to the now defunct Vancouver Whitecaps 2. This year, the team's home would be renamed Widener Field, as Widener Apartment Homes would acquire naming rights. 2017 was apparently a wild ride for the Switchbacks, so much so that an ebook is available on Amazon. Seasonal Disorder, one Colorado Springs Switchbacks FC fan's journey through the 2017 USL season. $4.99, I'm not paying for that. The club would leave too many points out on the field despite winning their last three matches. For the first time in Switchback history, no playoffs, just missing by the skin of their teeth. Someone poured water on this damn thing because it began to multiply. Dark times are in store for the club despite the talent, reaching their lowest point in most statistical areas in 2018. Colorado Springs had a brief turnaround mid-season, but sight of the playoffs were lost after this. The roster would receive an overhaul following this campaign. Luke Vercoloni retired and Josh Suggs headed home to New Mexico, as well as many, many, many other changes. However, there is some good news for the Trailheads, as a new stadium would be on the horizon, which is expected to feature trails, camping areas, and a zip line. In the past few years, the Switchbacks had struggled, but they weren't the worst, like Tulsa. They would avoid being the butt of every joke for the most part, until 2019. This season, the roster was in rebuild mode, suffering two very long winless streaks, going 9, then 11 games before finding a win. 2019 also saw the first Four Corners Cup, a regional soccer competition between Colorado Springs, New Mexico, Phoenix, and the Real Monarchs, a competition of which the Switchbacks came last. Of course, there would be no playoffs for the Swooshbacks, going headfirst off a steep hiking trail, hitting every rock and tree until landing at the bottom of the Western table. Looking forward, there are many reasons to be optimistic for Colorado Springs fans. A new coach from FC Cincinnati, Alan Koch, will be replacing coach Tritschew. Former energy player Christian Volsky will also be on the roster, as well as regulars Rory Argueta and Jordan Burt. This season, the Switchbacks have what it takes to avoid the bottom. That spot is reserved for Tulsa, but the bike trail to the playoffs is a treacherous one. Many hazards await them along the way. The first will come in week one with the OKC Energy. Like a cougar waiting for an unexpected jogger, I feel the Energy have the advantage. OKC isn't rebuilding their roster, only adding missing pieces, welcoming new coaches, retaining key players, and signing new ones. The Switchbacks roster may not have all that's needed to overcome such a mauling. They will gain valuable experience from this beatdown, and the others, they will suffer, coming out a stronger team. I mean, that hasn't worked for Tulsa, but whatever. So maybe Switchback supporters should save that optimism for 2021 to coincide with the new downtown 8,000-seater stadium and logo debut. So I hope to see all my fellow Greens at Taft on March 7th as our glorious Energy FC take on the Colorado Springs Switchbacks. We will consume many alcohol libations and feast upon barbecue goat, and the soccer gods will be pleased.